Hello. Thanks for joining me for today's devotion. Today I want to end our week of devotions with a look at the severity of God's judgment on sin. You cannot escape the implications of Revelation 9, 15 through 18. But I want us to consider just how important that is. But before I do that, I want to quote Charles Spurgeon from his sermon, "Future Punishment is a Fearful Thing," to capture how I feel about teaching this topic. Spurgeon said, "You know how seldom I have forced upon your attention those terrible subjects which concern the state of the lost in hell. I have felt more at home in the drawings of mercy than the drivings of terror. I can most honestly plead innocence to the charge of delighting in declaring the torments of the finally impenitent, or of entering upon the discussion of the miseries of the lost with eagerness and enjoyment. He who searches all hearts knows that under an overwhelming sense of urgency and necessity, and purely out of the love to the souls of men, I bring before you the text which I have announced." So what does Revelation 9, 15 and 18 say? "So the four angels who had been prepared for the hour, the day, the month, and the year were released to kill a third of mankind." And verse 18 says, "By these three plagues, a third of mankind was killed by the fire and smoke and sulfur coming out of their mouths." When God releases this judgment of the sixth trumpet on the earth, one third of all people who are not sealed by God will die. All of these plagues and the judgments in Revelation point us to the severity of God's judgment on sin. We live in a time when too many churches want to emphasize what I would call the feel-good character traits of God. It's easy to point out that God is loving, merciful, and gracious because these traits are desirable and they make us feel good about ourselves. For example, 1 John 4:16 says, "So we have come to know and to believe the love that God has for us. God is love, and whoever abides in love abides in God, and God abides in him." James 5:11 reminds us how the Lord is compassionate and merciful. And when God meets with Moses in Exodus 34:6, God declared this about himself: the Lord, a God merciful and gracious, slow to anger and abounding in steadfast love and faithfulness." The problem is too many people think those are the only attributes of God. All of God's attributes work together though, so we must consider all of his attributes to understand his character. For example, God is a just God, and his justice requires death for those who sin. Romans 6:23 says, "The wages of sin is death." God is holy as well. That means he is pure without any sin and cannot tolerate sin to be before him. In Exodus 33:20, God declares, "You cannot see my face, for man shall not see me and live." God's holiness and justice are just as much a part of God's character as his other attributes. When we think of God's justice, it would be necessary to think of it as loving justice and gracious justice, just as much as it would be correct to say about God's love that it is holy love and just love. So God's holiness demands justice to be done for sin. Every sin that has ever been committed will be punished. God's love is so great, though, that he provided the means by which Jesus paid the price for our sins so that all who place their faith in him will be saved. Hebrews 9:27 says, "It is appointed for man to die once, and after that comes judgment." If you do not believe in Christ during this life, you will pay the price for your sin. There are no second opportunities to believe. God's justice will be poured out on sin, but God's love has provided a way to be saved. And I want to end with Paul's words in 2 Corinthians chapter 5, starting in verse 20. "Therefore, we are ambassadors for Christ, God making his appeal through us. We implore you on behalf of Christ, be reconciled to God. For our sake, he made him to be sin who knew no sin, so that in him we might become the righteousness of God. Working together with him, then, we appeal to you not to receive the grace of God in vain. For he says, 'In a favorable time I listened to you, and in a day of salvation I have helped you. Behold, now is the favorable time. Behold, now is the day of salvation. I pray that today would be the day you accept Christ and you too would be saved. Thank you for joining me for today's devotion. God bless.